In recent years, independent programmers that makes their own game from scratches have populated the video game world. Most of the time, the team is built by one or two people. These games are known as indie. One of these programmers is Lucas Pope, who created some games that push the media's boundaries. This video will look at his red thread. A narrative thread connects all his works and runs through the themes he explores. Also, a video game has an active side that differentiates it from the other narrative media. It's a game, therefore you play it to proceed in the story. Pope likes to experiment. The games he creates experiment with the media pushing the player into emotional directions, either by the choices he has to make or the story the games tell. He likes the player to feel uncomfortable throughout his playthrough, witnessing some challenging events like gruesome murder or suicide. But what makes it hard for the player are the reasons behind actions. There are plenty of examples in the game he developed. In Paper Please, a game set on a state border where the player's character is an immigrant inspector for the communist-inspired fake country of Astrotska, he'll witness many people killed by the border guards because they try to go over the border wall trying to escape, or people killing themselves by suicide bombing as an act of terrorism to topple the country's power. Witnessing these events, the player is left to question his job and how they can try to prevent these episodes from happening. But any decision he takes has a consequence, either on his family or the country. He has to find the right balance. The other example of shocking deaths is Return to the Obra Dinn, where the character has to investigate the fate of all the crew members, most of who died in a very gruesome way. But what gets the player is again the reason: few men's greed. This example allows us to talk about the second thread, detective work. All Lucas Pope game's core is based around detective work. The player has to check clues, guess and reconstruct evidence to make his decision. The active parts seem very small, the player has very few active actions, like pressing only a couple of buttons, but the work behind it is enormous. His games will keep the player constantly engaged and with a resolve to get all the pieces right before making a decision. In Paper Please, the player has to check all manner of details of the migrants' papers to make sure he can allow them in the country. Even the slightest mistake can result in a fine that will take money away from the character's family. On top of that, most people who ask to enter will work up to the player's sympathy, trying to lower his attention to details. In Return to the Obra Dinn, the entire ship is a gigantic crime scene. The first part of the game serves as a tutorial ending in a suicide. Throughout it, the game pushes the player to want to know what happened on the ship, making him crave to uncover the truth by analyzing every single detail. The last thread has been lightly touched upon already: morality. All Pope games deal with morality, with the world the players are immersed in. They will see a world where what is right is relative. Every non-playable character will have their take on the solutions for problems, making the games have a whiff of realism and making the player go up and down on an emotional roller coaster. For example, in Paper Please, the Astrotskian government will change who can enter the country and who can't, leaving the player with guards that offer bribes to get more people detained so they can get a bonus on their paycheck. The player will also deal with homeless people begging to be let in even if they don't have the correct documents. In Return to the Obra Dinn, while you uncover the crew's fate, you discover who they were and how they dealt with other people. The story of the ship's crew is very complicated, with people betraying, protecting, killing, or trying to save other people. I won't go into many details because I hope you decide to play it yourself. On a personal note, Lucas Pope can be considered a complete game author, having done everything himself from writing the story to program the games. In an industry where graphics and big action are usually the most important thing, he decided to go in the opposite direction, little action with retro graphics, but with a big push on emotional intensity and mental work. I look forward to his following projects. In the description, you'll find a link to both games. Onward to the next author!